नमस्ते स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम जीवन डॉक्टर अजीज मोहम्मद खान फ्रॉम डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ फूड एंड बायोटेक्नोलॉजी, फैकल्टी ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर एंड वेटरनरी साइंस, ज्योति विद्यापीठ वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी जयपुर। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द इंट्रोडक्शन टू माइक्रोबायोलॉजी। माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म, व्हाट आर द माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म? माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म वो होते हैं जो सब जगह होते हैं, दे आर एवरीवेयर। For example, they are on the hands, they are on our bed, they are in the toilets, they are at our home, they are in the soil, they are in the air. So they are everywhere. And most microorganisms are harmless. They do not harm us. The example is that some of the microbes are in our body, that they help us in digestion. They help us in digestion of food. Without the help of these microbes, we cannot digest our food. And daily life, we swallow millions of microbes. Similarly, some of microbes also help in running biosphere because they decompose the unusual or dead animals, plants, so they recycle all the things and they decompose. They make possible a cycle of carbon, oxygen and nitrogen. Some of the microorganisms can cause disease in man, animal and plants, so they are also harmful. Some of them are harmful and they cause some infectious disease. The example is that Great Plague, which reduced the population of Europe about 25%. Similarly, smallpox was also a disease. At this time, coronavirus, that is a pandemic disease, is also caused by a virus. Now we come to the history of the microbiology. The first thing is that germ theory. I will not discuss a lot about the history because this is not in our topic. So, germ theory. In 1876, Robert Koch proved the germ theory. What is the germ theory? It means that some centuries ago, the people believed that the disease arises due to their बैड कैरेक्टर्स, ड्यू टू देयर सिंस, मीन्स वो कोई गलत काम करते हैं उससे उनको बीमारियाँ होती है। कोई गलत काम करता है, कोई क्राइम करता है उससे उनको बीमारियाँ होता है। दे डिड नॉट नो अबाउट द माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म, उनको माइक्रोब्स के बारे में कुछ भी नहीं पता था। बट कोच पोस्टुलेट के अकॉर्डिंग जो डिजीज होती है वो होती है माइक्रोब्स के, जर्म्स की वजह से। ठीक है, तो फर्स्ट टाइम कोच ने ही बताया था, रॉबर्ट कोच ने ही हमें बताया था कि जो डिजीज होती है वो माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म से होती है। उन्होंने एंथ्रेक्स, जो एक बीमारी होती है उसके कॉजेटिव एजेंट, दैट इज बेसिलस एंथ्रेक्स, और टीबी, ट्यूबरक्लोसिस, उसके माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म के बारे में पता लगाया था। Some more scientists also studied about the role of microorganisms in disease, including Pasteur, who saw that microbes can cause disease, and Joseph Lister, Robert Koch, and Charles Chamberlain. And in the Koch postulate, microbes must be present in every case of the disease, but absent from the healthy individuals, and the suspected microbes can be isolated. According to Koch, the suspected, it means that if anthrax is caused by the microbes, then we can isolate the causative microorganism from the individual that is suffering from the anthrax. And the disease must result when the isolated microorganism is inoculated into the healthy host. So one unhealthy people can cause and infect the healthy people due to these infections. Isolation of microorganisms was also conducted by some scientists. For example, Robert Koch, he isolated some microbes from techniques of by using the gelatin and melted gelatin. Then Fanny Ellis-Mays used agar. He melted agar and cooled it for the solidification for the preparation of media. Then Louis Pasteur, that is also known as the father of the modern microbiology, and Louis Pasteur developed vaccines for the chickenpox, anthrax, rabies. He demonstrated all the fermentation. He also developed the pasteurization technique. He discovered the fermented microbes with anaerobic properties. And Louis Pasteur developed a spontaneous generation theory. In this theory, he gave that the microbes are the causative agent for the food spoilage. For example, he used a snagged flask. In these snagged flask, he heated the food material inside it, and he closed the lid of the snagged flask, so it is closed. After some times, it remained closed, and there will not appear any microbes. यहाँ पे कोई भी माइक्रोब्स की ग्रोथ नहीं आई थी. जब लुईस पाश्चर ने इसको देखा और इसको गर्म किया, गर्म करने के बाद में इसको काफ़ी टाइम तक रखा, और रखने के बाद में इसको ऑब्जर्व किया तो यहाँ पे कोई भी माइक्रोब्स की ग्रोथ नहीं हुई थी. लेकिन उसके बाद में जब उन्होंने इसकी लिड, इसकी जो ओपन लिड है, जो इसका कवर है इसका, जब ओपन कर दिया उसको एयर के कांटेक्ट में लेके आए, तो यहाँ पे जो जो ये फूड है वो कंटामिनेट हो गया, और यहाँ पे ये माइक्रोब्स के कांटेक्ट में है और ये स्पॉइल हो गया. द फूड वाज स्पॉइल्ड ड्यू टू द कांटेक्ट इन द माइक्रोब्स. नाउ कम टू द टॉपिक, दैट इज माइक्रोबायोलॉजी. Microbiology is the study of microorganisms that are invisible to the naked eye. What are the invisible things? We know that 1 centimeter is there, then 1 millimeter is there, and then comes micrometer. Micrometer. So the microbes whose size are in the micrometer are known as the microorganism, and the study of these microbes are known as the microbiology. For example, 100 micrometer, 10 micrometer. So these are the size of the microorganism, and the study of these microbes is known as the microbiology. And the subjects of microbiology may include the virus, says bacteria and algae, fungi, protozoa, and the importance of microbiology cannot be overemphasized. Right? The modern biotechnology is also dependent on the microbiology, because microbiology is a field that is directly related to biotechnology, molecular biology, immunology. So some other fields are also included in the microbiology. What are the scope of microbiology? Many microbiologists are the people who study and who are involved in the study of microbes are known as the microbiologist. But we expand it. When we expand it, then we can say that the people who study about the virus are known as the virologists. The people who study about the bacteria are known as a bacteriologist. The people who study about the algae are known as a phycologist, and the people who study about the fungi are known as the mycologist. And the protozoa are studied by protozoologist. And the microbiology have a great impact on medicine, agriculture, food science, ecology, genetics, biochemistry, immunology, and other fields. For example, the medical microbiology is the science, is the field of science which deals with the humans and disease in humans and animals and their health care services. Immunology is the study of immune system. Agriculture microbiology is the study of microorganism in the agriculture fields, and the food and dietary microbiology is the field which deals with the production of food through microorganism, and dairy is in the same field, which is directly related to production of dairy related food products from the microorganism. Industrial microbiology is the field which is the use of some important kind of products from microorganisms. For example, antibiotics, vaccines, steroids are produced and synthesized from the use of microorganisms. So it is also a great field of microbiology. Then genetic engineering is the field of microbiology or science that is related to study of genetic organization of microbes. In the upcoming lecture, we will discuss about the classification of microorganisms. So our lecture is over here. Thank you very much.